Last time on Battletech Revised.
A lot has happened since the last video, so here's a recap. After thrusting the Sword of Restoration through Victoria Espinosa's cockpit, I returned back to my homeland of Bromhead in the Federated Suns, having become an ally with House Davion. When I went to check out the faction store, I managed to find two pieces of an atlas, and I bought them instantly. Between all of the variants I could build from, there were two options. The Atlas RS, which was known for having two energy hardpoints in each arm, or the Atlas 7A, which replaces the AC-20 with five SRM-6s. I mean, the choice is obvious. Come on. As for how I'm going to build this thing...
Now, back to the show.
This video is sponsored by Raid Wasp Repellent. Pesky wasps and stingers harassing you on the tabletop? With the power of Raid, see them cower in fear before you. Find it at your local hardware store today. So, thank you to all of the voice actors and volunteers who have helped make this project possible. This has been like a passion project I've been working on for like a year and a half, and this would have not been possible without these guys. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. A little disclaimer before I get into the rest of the video. This video is based on Battletech Revised. Great mod pack, I've played it a lot. I'm running on a really old version. December 2021, January 22. It was 6 months old then. It's still quite old, and some stuff may have been patched out. Some details might have been changed. Download it and try it yourself to see what it actually is. This is not vanilla Battletech or something. So, with Battletech's first DLC, they introduced these things called flashpoints. They basically act as short little story missions with branching paths and important choices. They're usually pretty cool, and sometimes they actually have some like real narrative weight to them. One such flashpoint is the one you get when you ally with one of the great houses operating in this part of the periphery, such as the Davion Alliance flashpoint. Now, I know what you are thinking.
But why didn't you ally with House Steiner?
Why ally with House Davion, Angelique? Why not like House Steiner, Liao, or Arado, or Kirita, or Marik, or...
Yeah, I just did it for the Steam achievement, honestly. However, the thing with flashpoints is that there are only so many that can spawn on the star map at any one point. So, in order to get the Alliance flashpoint to spawn, I chose to tackle the Steel Beast.
Commander, I'm pleased to see that you have accepted my request. The matter that I have for you is one of a personal nature. My nephew Arjun has been murdered. Killed in the cockpit by a grandstanding fool in front of a cheering audience. I want his head. His name is Bogdan Tubbs, and he calls himself the Steel Beast. Under the guise of friendship, Tubbs challenged my nephew to a harmless exhibition match, but when Arjun stepped into the arena, the gladiator turned what should have been a friendly duel into a bloody execution. In the end, he crushed Arjun's cockpit with his battle mech's armored claw.
Did somebody pay him to do it? What was his motivation?
Fame, the roar of the crowd, who can guess? In truth, Miss Murad, I couldn't care less what drove that gladiator to kill dear Arjun. I care only that justice of House Steiglitz Bradford and House Steiner is visited upon this steel beast, and that Bogdan Tubbs pays for Arjun's death with his own life.
If you can lure this gladiator out to the remote periphery, yeah, we'll take care of him for you.
Alas, I cannot, but you can. One of the Steel Beast's biggest sponsors, Ironwood Productions, has a holovid distribution facility fight here on HEROTITUS. And just so happens that Ironwood Productions is hosting a major fan event for Tubbs' most ardent supporters. I want you to make a mockery of the Steel Beast's retinue. Smash them to pieces, stomp them flat, send them running back to whatever cave they crawled out of. And I want you to record yourself doing it. After you've destroyed the Steel Beast supporters, I want you to proceed to Ironwood Productions' hollow recording facility and capture it. You will then use the equipment inside to broadcast the challenge to Solaris 7 and beyond. The Steel Beast will be powerless to resist such a challenge. He will come to you, and you will kill him for what he did to my nephew.
In that case, we're on it.
You have my thanks. Return to me when your challenge has been recorded, and we'll lure Arjun's killer to us.
So, after waiting for my Atlas to finish building, as well as using our black market contacts to stop a viral outbreak, I then had the Deckers field test the new Atlas against whatever poor sobs found themselves on the receiving end of these missiles.
Our surveillance drones have spotted a group of the Steel Beast's friends and followers near this location. Understand that these people aren't trained mercenaries. They are a motley crew of Solaris gladiators, pirates, and highwaymen. Most don't belong on the battlefield at all, let alone in a battlemech's cockpit. It should be a trivial matter for you to smash them flat.
Okay, so first loading in. This seems like a pretty easy fight. We got two, maybe three contacts up north. And then we deal with that, and then we go home. At least, that's what I thought, until Darius...
I've got eyes on hostile reinforcements. They're heading your way.
Darius, come on, man.
Hold them for tactical
advantage. I know it's your job, but these are not reinforcements. They were here from the beginning.
Okay, wait your command.
They're just another force here.
Yes, command.
Anyway, with that in mind, my plan didn't really change. So the plan was to just move forward, deal with those three, and then just turn around and deal with the guys behind us. I mean, we have an Atlas here, as well as the double tap dragon. These things won't last long. Why is it called the double tap dragon, you ask? That's why.
Critical hit.
Hey, Decker, give him hell.
The burning you feel? It is shame. Fucking
insatiable! Ready.
That tickles.
How many times do we have to teach you this?
Dealing with those two is pretty easy from here. The Atlas just finishes off the Crusader.
Mech destroyed.
And the overheating Ostrock, which is kind of insult to injury, firing more inferno ammo. But yeah, so then in the meantime, Archangel, Banjo,
I'm here.
Prepare to welcome our new guests while Decker and Decker clean up here.
Got a lock. Target acquired. Got a commander.
Hey, Grasshopper. Knocked off. Aren't you gonna say who's there?
The rest of the fight went pretty uneventfully. Merlin tried his best.
I fell down!
And then was put down pretty quickly. And then the last Merlin that was hiding out in the back, after seeing what happened to his kin, was put down just as swiftly.
Affected.
Meaning clean sweep.
Reporting crit. Enemy eliminated.
That was glorious, Commander. You beat them bloody without a shred of hesitation or remorse.
And I captured the entire show in Holovid. Nice, crisp footage, ready for air.
Then by all means, we should broadcast it. We move on to Ironwood Productions and their holo distribution facility, and we do it now.
What about refits and repairs? Our lash took fire down there.
I am paying you to deliver swift justice for Arjun's murder, Mr. Vertanen. Anything short of that is unacceptable. You will move on to Ironwood's hollow distribution facility, and you will do it without delay.
You're the boss, Graf Stieglitz Bradford. If you say we push forward, then we push forward.
Mission successful.
Before we go on to the rest of the battle, I want to go on a tangent about this Thunderbolt, because the way AMS works in Battletech Revise is that any mech that can theoretically mount an AMS, as long as it has a support hardpoint in the left torso. This Thunderbolt has three, and I think it's the only mech in the game that does. So I just bring this thing along because it has three AMSs and just cuts down any missiles in the way. It's like, I think the following clip sums it up nicely.
Distribution facility should be just ahead of you, Commander.
Indeed. Ironwood Productions uses this facility to mass-produce holovid entertainment for combat enthusiasts across the Inner Sphere. They have everything we'll need to issue the Steel Beast a challenge he cannot refuse. I would advise your Lance to scout the facility before engaging it. Ironwood Productions has security contracts with a number of local mercenary outfits, and resistance is likely to be heavy.
Oh, shut up, Darius. You don't get to speak.
I see a lot of green out of my cockpit.
All right, gentlemen. We got contact on screen. Stag defenses and mech forces as well. Don't have us in a kill zone when we beat the ridge. I'll need you on your A-game today, as we are to take this facility with extreme prejudice and make a fool out of these motley defenders. Now, dig in your heels, as here they come.
Sensors locked on. Lifting off.
Coming.
Locking on target. I've been tanked a lot.
Look at these turrets. Who designed these? Someone here is overcompensating, and it sure as hell ain't me.
Confirm.
So the plan here is, the Atlas and the Black Knight pull aggro, while the Black Dagger and the Phoenix are getting close to finish them off with a twist of the knife.
Firing. My armor's getting stripped off.
We'll center that, you big baby.
The plan seems to have worked, actually, and the Black Knight was able to take its just revenge by the end of it. Soon we got eyes on the facility.
And we have eyes on you. I'd advise against doing anything foolish, Commander. This studio is better defended than most frontier military bases, and I'd like nothing better than to justify our defense budget.
These turrets are a real pain in the ass, man.
Can't say I didn't warn you.
I'm still reading enemy contacts, Commander. You need to secure the area before you can proceed.
And here's what we think of the Wolverine!
My Phoenix Hawk is in Death From Above range of this turret. Now, I will turn to my local Death From Above expert, my good friend, the Seas of Envy. Seas, do you think I should DFA right here?
Let's see, we're in DFA range.
Yeah!
Too hot. Shutting down.
The skill beast. Is that the guy we're fighting later? With the turrets down and all garrison forces eliminated, we have a quiet turn to wake up the Atlas 54 more bogeys closing. Wait, what? No, that's... What are we fighting? This is a Phoenix Hawk with like 6 evasion and 4 and just took out a leg.
Commander!
Just what the hell did we get ourselves into?
Fuck this shit, I'm out. No tanks!
This is taking it hard out here, Commander.
That's what she said!
All weapons are gone! Hostile eliminated.
Oh god, that's where I'm carrying!
Affirmative.
I wasn't scared, you were scared, huh?
So, at this point in my notes, I had BJ explosion ring down, and it gave me a bit of a giggle.
Location,
but, come on guys, that's a bit immature. I like to think my humor is a little more highbrow than that. So, after absolutely cream-pieing the Vindicator, leaving it lying on the ground all high and steamy, there was only a demolisher left to deal with. I mean, look at this thing. This is a custom demolisher mounting how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 AC-2s firing precision ammo? I mean, whoever designed this must have an AC-2 finish or something.
Welcome back to the dramatic conclusion of the AC-2 campaign. And we are ready to kick some ass.
Truly, truly a madman right there. And just like that, the second mission of the Flashpoint was complete.
I am inbound for landing, Commander.
You win. Onward Productions is officially Crown Uncle. The holo distribution facility is yours for as long as you need it. If you want to call it the Steel Beast, we can help you do that. In fact, we'd be happy to.
I bet you will. Someone in your fight promotions department is probably doing a happy little dance right now.
We know a money-making opportunity when we hear it. When you're ready, come on in. We got a dozen holo cameras ready to roll.
Excellent. The victory brings a step closer to justice for my murdered nephew. I suggest that you prepare yourselves. You'll be receiving the Steel Beast's challenge soon enough.
Mission successful.
We're getting an incoming message, Commander. It's Tubbs. It looks like he's already here, and I'll bet that he's mighty pissed off.
That's a surprise. Isn't he supposed to be on Solaris 7?
Buckle in, Commander. I'm putting him up on the view screen now.
Hey! Commander, shit for brains! I saw your little holo broadcast. You think you can handle the crushing power of the Steel Beast? Well, I'm here to call you out and challenge your best to a duel to the death!
You've got to be kidding me, Tubbs. Is this really how you talk?
You're goddamn right it is. The Steel Beast is as real as it gets. He practices 100% sincerity, and he's gonna cut through your bullshit with a snap of his claws. You're about to face the unbridled, armored fury of Solaris 7's most notorious welterweight champion.
Welterweight, huh? Interesting. With all the yelling and screaming, I expected you to pilot something bigger.
Stay out of it, lady. This is between me and your company's champion, my crab, against your best medium mech. Now, are you going to accept my challenge, or are you a bunch of sniveling cowards with jelly where your spine should be?
Yeah, you've got your fight. And when the dust settles, there won't be enough left of you to fill a 5-gallon jug.
You think you can frighten the steel beast? You don't scare me. It is I who scares you. I'll see you on the goddamn field.
You versus our best, one-on-one. We'll be there. So, boss, we're gonna drop the whole lance right down on the asshole's head, right? Please tell me that's what we're about to do.
No, Yang. We made a deal. A fair fight, one-on-one. That's what we're gonna do. And we're going to make boiled crab out of him. Duelists for Battletech Revised, because it has 6 support hardpoints, in which I mount 6 flamers, and then it has another 6 energy hardpoints to go along with it. Medium lasers, in Battletech Revised, deal 1 point of heat damage in addition to its regular damage, because I don't know if it's a balancing mechanic or just flavor, but that adds to the amount of heat this Blackjack can generate. This Blackjack also has a quirk, internal pre-igniter, which causes every flamer to deal +1 heat damage in addition to everything else, and a Guardian ECM to let me get in close and actually bring these flamers and medium lasers to bear makes this thing a really scary one-on-one duelist, because it can just, unless you're a heat-neutral mech, this thing will shut you down, and then it will flank you and keep shutting you down. This thing is nuts, and I love it. Alright, it's Saturday night. I got no date, a 2-liter bottle of Shasta, and my All Rush mixtape. Let's rock.
Command interface initiated.
You're here! Good. I've been looking forward to breaking your neck.
Shut up and fight, you murderous swine. Commander, we'll make you suffer, as you made my nephew Arjun suffer.
Suffering? I'll show you suffering. Get ready for a taste of the big steel claw. Big steel claw!
I have no words.
What is wrong with him?
It's his catchphrase! He screams it before every battle! Now get out there and make us some money, huh? We got cameras rolling on this!
Bring it on!
I've got eyes on hostile reinforcements. They're heading your way.
Shut up, Darius!
Yeah, Darius? Fuck you.
So I've got reinforcements to deal with too. Great.
A blackjack? Your champion mech is a blackjack? Overheat? What do you mean overheat?
You got it.
Merchandising rights!
That hit something good.
Hey there, Commander! I brought friends. Acquaintances? Meat shields. I brought meat shields.
This is going to be harder than I thought.
Ah, damn it! This will never count to my score. Weapon critical, weapon of the line. Ah, damn it, damn it, damn it!
You like that?
What sick man sends babies to fight me?
eject, eject. Where's the eject?
All right, Mr. C, let's do this dance again, motherfucker. Crabs back on the menu, boys.
Valhalla awaits.
Shit! Crabs back on the menu, boys!
Open the gates. I'm coming home.
Scratch one steel beast. The miserable fool cheated and we still took him down.
And I salute you for it. Arjun's death has been avenged. May it bring his poor parents some measure of comfort.
Mission successful.
An impressive performance, Commander. You played the bastard's game and crushed him, both physically and metaphorically. My nephew's untimely death has been avenged.
We were pleased to be of service, Grubsty Glitz Bradford. Bloodthirsty fools like Tubbs give all mech warriors a bad name.
Not anymore, my friend. You and your company have solved that problem admirably. And now, if you'll excuse me, I have family matters to attend to in Tharkad. Arjun had a son whose affairs must be seen to, and now that honor has been satisfied, that duty falls on my shoulders.
Until next time, Graf Stieglitz Bradford.
Until then, be well, Commander.
And here we see a prime example on how to not use a locust.
In the eyes of those who anxiously seek perfection, a work is never truly completed, a word that for them has no sense, but abandoned. I say this as this video is a passion project for me. I mean, for fuck's sake, I've been working on it sporadically since January 2022, and it's like, there's a lot of stuff here that's unpolished. There's a lot of corners that have been cut, like the actual scripting I wrote for the voice actors, that's probably like maybe a half, maybe two-thirds of what's actually there that I just cut down for the sake of keeping this project within meaningful scope. Then there were like entire other music segments that have been cut. There have been entire memes and one-offs and stuff that I just couldn't figure out how to include within a reasonable time frame. Heck, this entire thing with the steel beast was supposed to be like the first half of a video, a lead up towards the Davian Alliance flashpoint that you saw at the end. Yeah, no, I don't think I'm getting that within the next year and a half either. So it's like, and there's just so many little details, so much effort put into minor things on the back end of this project that few people will notice or even appreciate. And it's just, I could probably make this like an hour long video if I could, if I wanted to, but I know it needs to end here. So, as you can probably tell, this is probably the one part of the video that is purely unscripted. I just have like a bullet pointed list and I'm going on. It's just this, of course, means a lot to me, so I put in a lot of effort whenever I do sit down and actually work on this thing. And it feels both cathartic and kind of sad that it's coming to an end. So, you ask me, why has this video taken so long? Yeah, but take this in stride, viewers. Go on, create. Shout your passions from the high heavens so that all will know you like this thing, whatever your thing is. Go on, create as much as you can before you drop dead. Yeah, and on that note, here are a bunch of outtakes and a bunch of like one-off jokes I couldn't otherwise incorporate. Such as the Davion Alliance Well, that's going on the blooper reel. You think you can fight the Steel Beast? You don't scare me. It is I who scares you! I'll see you on the goddamn field! What the hell am I doing?
Do it without delay.
You're the boss. Oh god, how am I gonna pronounce that?
Mission successful.
Shit. Fuck. Fuck, that was such a good take and I was muted.
Let's see, we're in the FA range.
Yeah! You're the boss, Graf Stieglitz. Stieglitz. You're the boss, I'm gonna just say the rest of the lines and then just have like a cut. It's gonna be very awkward. You're the boss. You're the boss. You're the boss. If you say we push forward, then we push forward.
No! My cabbages! No, my cabbages! My cabbages! My cabbages! Oh, you're gonna pay for that. You know what? Fuck you, Darius. You know what? Fuck you, Darius. Fuck you, Darius. Hey, Commander, I brought some, friends. Hope you don't mind. Hey there, Commander. Brought some backup. Hope you don't mind. You know, you normally have to fight through a tournament roster to fight me, so, I decided to abbreviate it a bit. A blackjack. Really, a blackjack? What, are you gonna drop armor at me? Oh, I didn't know you were a Fed Rat, Commander. Ah, look, the Commander's a little Fed Rat with his blackjack. Hey there, Commander! Nice blackjack. You gonna tickle me with those AC2s? Ah, AC2s, how cute. Hey there, Commander! Eat laser! You know, the speed's of light... You know, the speed of light is a bit of a bitch, especially when... Eat photons! Eat photons, Commander! Hey, you want some crab claw in your mouth?